folks, we're here live in Island Pond, Vermont at the Vintage Snowmobile Show. So if you're in the area, you want to come on down because we're having a really good turnout. And this is especially cool because this is their first time doing a show and they're getting an excellent turnout. So kudos to the people of Kingdom Grill, which is right there, that building right there. They're the ones putting this on. And there's some people here I know, people I don't know, ones I know or have agreed to talk with me, if I can catch them live. But let's go down the row here and look at some of these sleds. I should have started at this end, but what are you going to do? Oops, sorry. So in case you're just joining us, we're live here right now in Island Pond, Vermont at the Vintage Snowmobile Show. Are these yours?
No,
sure. No? Alright, cool. You said you have sleds here though?
Yeah, I got a Harley Davidson down there on the end.
Oh, cool.
73 Harley.
We're live on Facebook right now with 74 viewers. Do you want to talk up your sled?
Well, it's a 73 that I haven't done nothing to yet. I got a few sleds.
You want to walk over and stand next to it?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, let's...
Does that pause?
No, we're just going live, but we got 80 people. And
80 people so far?
Yeah, I don't know, I'll give you my card. With Vintage Snowmobile Lovers? No,
okay. No, I've been going to these things for 20 years.
Nice.
And like I said, I got a couple of Polaris's that I'm working on right now, and they'll be mint when I get done. I mean, I got $1,000 into two hoods, you know?
Sweet, are you from around here?
From New York, but I live in Island Pond now.
Yeah, nice.
I live out on... What's it, Route 114 going out of town.
Yeah, nice, toward Canaan.
Yep.
Sweet. Yeah, if you want to just, you know, my name is, and this is my, and just kind of talk it up like you're telling a friend about it.
My name is Mike Galloway. It's a 73 Harley Davidson. It's got a 440 engine with a 18-inch track on it. I've got it about 2 months ago. I haven't done a thing to it yet. She starts right up and runs. But like I say, I'm into restoring them, so eventually it will look really pretty, and I'll bring it with my other ones and we'll show them off, you know?
Nice.
And hopefully we can keep this thing going so that we get more people to show up. I mean, there should be people coming from all over the country to this place, but it's, you know, snowmobile heaven for Vermonters.
It sure is,
so,
yeah.
So, you know, if we can get more people out here, the better off the chances we're going to have this thing to keep going. So, I mean, I was feeling like crap this morning, but I said, hey, I'm going to get down there and at least bring one of my sleds down.
Sure.
There it is.
Nice. Let's do a quick walk around of it. Any anything you want to talk up on it? Anything
no, it's just a little choke on it. I mean, we're missing a couple of things. Oh, shit, she fires up first pull.
Yeah, nice.
That don't sound good.
That's a sweet ride, though. You said it was 73?
73 Harley, yep.
Very nice. Yeah, that's cool.
I guess Harley made them without the AMF name on it for a few years, but I never saw it.
Sure.
I didn't really like that little noise it made.
Yeah, yeah. Was that, like a backfire or something? Or?
Well, it sounded like people just roughly stopped. Yeah. Keep going.
Good.
Hey, do you know that sled, do you?
Huh?
You know that sled?
I sold it to you.
Nah, you didn't. I bought it off this dirt bag over across the way. What's going on, Bernie? Barney? No trucking today, huh?
No.
You hear that bop in it?
Huh?
You hear that crank in it?
Nice meeting you. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank
you.
Where
are we going?
What's that?
We're going to chuck them up here and take off. We'll cross the pond.
All right, yeah. Let's walk around, look at some more sleds here. Yeah, in case you're just joining us, we're live here in Island Pond, Vermont at the Vintage Snowmobile Show. They've had a hell of a turnout. This is really, really exciting. Kudos. I mean, three twin tracks in a row. Doesn't get better than that, does it? And this event is put on by the nice folks over at Kingdom Grill, that blue building behind us there. Those are the nice folks putting this on. So if you're ever in Island Pond, definitely stop by. My girlfriend and I had dinner there the other night, or last weekend, I should say, and we had an excellent meal. I'm going to say hi to a friend of mine here. You've probably seen him on the show before. How's it going?
How's it going?
Good. Hey.
Hey, how you doing?
Good. You're live in front of 120 people.
Yeah.
You want to say anything? Seeing you, man. How you been?
Yeah, good. You?
Good. Good.
That's cool. I've never seen anything like that before.
No, that vertical pipe? That's crazy. Two of them.
Two pipe.
That's crazy.
I've never seen that.
That's crazy.
No, I just want to warm up a little bit. You're going to be around for a while.
We'll be here all day, yeah. Yeah, we'll have to talk up your sleds.
Yeah, my feet are getting a little cold. I got
to move. Move around. Yeah, definitely. Maybe I'll get this guy to talk up his sled.
Yeah.
How you doing? That's amazing with those vertical pipes. We're live on Facebook right now with 123 people watching. Do you feel like talking this up? Just, you know, my name is, and talk it up.
71 Lanks Wankel 303 rotary motor.
Wow.
Not a lot of them, but they made them for a couple of years.
Sure. What can you tell me about these vertical pipes? I've never seen anything like that.
Well, somebody decided to make it a mod, so they used to make a 734 mod, 634 and 7. The pipes come out the side.
Sure, Montana pipes?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Somebody came up with this idea. I didn't do it. I traded one of my vintage sleds for this one.
Sure.
Just had to have it.
Yeah, that's amazing. You know what? I'm going to get crazy here. I'm going to name those Idaho pipes because they're
there
vertical.
You
know, Idaho is like a vertical looking state.
Yeah.
Getting crazy and just
perfect.
Trying new things.
Sounds good to me.
Let me give you my business card. I'm on Facebook. Are you familiar with Vintage Snowmobile Lovers? Over 50,000 fans. It's the largest community of vintage snowmobile enthusiasts anywhere, Facebook or otherwise.
Cool.
And we do a live podcast every week. And
really?
Yeah.
Nice. Thank you.
You wouldn't by any chance fire that up again, would you?
Certainly.
That had a hell of a note going by. That was wonderful. That's amazing. Yeah, that you got. That is amazing. Where are you based out of?
Kirby, Vermont.
Kirby, Vermont. All right.
Not far.
What was your name again?
Bob Halpin.
Help, H-A-L-P-I-N.
Yep.
Nice. Are you on Facebook? Can I look you up?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yep. I am the trail master for Caledonia County Snowmobile Trail Club.
Yeah, nice.
I got to go get my clothespin so I can put my label on.
Yes,
yeah.
Totally. Well, yeah, great meeting you, man.
You
Thank
too.
You so much
you
for talking
too.
That up.
All right.
That was a moment right there with those pipes. Cool deal. All right, man. Nice meeting you.
You too. Thanks.
All right, let's continue the quest for excitement here. How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good. Hi there, is this yours?
No.
No?
I'm just trying my first sled was a 65.
Just like this?
Yeah, well, it was a twin cylinder flat.
Yeah?
My son has it now.
Oh, wow, is it
when
here?
He does it at, he's going to bring it, I'm sure.
Yeah? You Do you mind being on camera?
You know Reno?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I'm sure.
All right.
He'll be done.
He'll be over?
Oh, yeah, he's got the...
Well, cool. Well, yeah, well, nice meeting you. What was your name?
Gervais,
okay.
I'm Sir Gervais.
Are you from Island Pond?
Yeah.
I know there's a lot of Gervais in Island Pond.
I'm the original.
Oh, really?
I was the first one here.
The patriarch, wow.
1965.
Wow, that's cool.
Yeah.
Wow. You must know Paul and Sylvia King?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Paul has passed away, of course, but that was my aunt and uncle.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, Sylvia is my mother's sister.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, excuse me.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
Well, cool. Well, yeah, it was really nice to meet you.
Same here.
Yeah, enjoy your day. Mike LaPierre.
LaPierre.
You know, yeah, oui. Oui, monsieur. Do you know the paint store in Newport?
Yeah.
The LaPierre and Sons?
Yeah.
That was my uncle that used to have that.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Yeah, he's retired now. He sold it, but yeah, it was his store. Yeah. Well, cool. Yeah, I've got, I'm going to walk around and get some more footage, but it was great to meet you.
Same here.
All right, have a good day. Sorry. Are any of these yours? We're live right now on Facebook with 116 people. You want to talk it up? Because you know my name is, and just talk it up. Sure, yeah, get right in the shot.
68 Alberg. 69 Alberg.
69 Alberg. And what was your name again?
John Tilton.
Tilton. K-I-L-T-O-N?
T-I-L.
Oh, T-I-L-T-O-N. Sorry, with that sled going.
Yeah.
But in fact, we'll give him a... Here we go. Yeah, if you want to talk it up.
Well, there ain't much to talk about it. I've had it probably 25 years or so.
25 years or so, yeah.
Got enough friends. I've had another one that I used to park. Kept apart. Over there. Brother's done some work over the last couple of weeks with my nephew.
Yeah.
They stayed up till 11 o'clock last night trying to get the carburetor working.
I'm going to lay in the snow over there.
Sure. What can you tell us about the Alberg brand?
Originally it came out of the Alouette. Alouette made the basics of it.
Yeah.
I'm going to. Starcraft 2.
So is it made in Quebec, or?
Yeah.
It is, okay, yeah. Good.
I've been finding this out on Google.
Oh, yeah, okay, doing some research?
Yeah. I've only met one other guy here today that he's gotten one more machine.
Wow, so they're pretty rare then, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mostly a Canadian type machine.
Mostly up in Quebec? Yeah.
Well, yeah, Starcraft, they had their own machine for a while.
Yeah.
Came
very cool.
Years,
yeah.
I guess pretty much the same thing.
Okay, yeah.
What I've seen on Google, each of the 2 years that they made the Alberg, they made five different models. And this is the 20.
Yeah. Now, what does the 20 stand for?
I'm not 100% sure. Some of them could have meant like it had a 20 horse engine.
Sure, okay.
I've got a book at home that shows how you can really boost the horsepower on it.
Yeah.
Going to port and polish into the exhaust system and putting a cuny on it and then stuff.
Nice.
I just run it.
Sure. And this was registered in Vermont in the 72-73 season?
Yeah.
And 73-74 season.
Yep.
Oh, and 73 as well.
Got another one down here.
Oh, yes, look at that. Very cool.
Yeah, I'm out of Washington, Vermont.
What's that?
I'm out of Washington, Vermont.
Washington, Vermont, okay. Yep. Are you part of the Snow Flyers when they have that show? Or?
No.
No.
This is the first show this has been in.
Oh, wow, good. Let me give you my card. I'm with Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. We're on Facebook.
Yep.
We do a podcast every week and a lot of videos on there. Yeah, if you're on Facebook at all, you should check us out.
I've seen one video, but the guy was covering the one over Lancaster, New Hampshire.
Yeah, I cover a lot of those, yeah. Nice. Cool deal.
Yep.
Well, yeah, I appreciate your time, man. It was nice to meet you.
Thank you.
All righty, yeah, thanks for showing that.
Yeah.
Cool deal.
Today,
yeah, it's airing live now, so when you get home, if you get on Facebook, get on Vintage Snowmobile Lovers, the Facebook page, scroll down a bit, you'll see the live coverage.
Okay.
I'm going to try to interview as many people as I can, and then later I'll download it and I'll chop it up, you know, into little videos to put on the podcast and on the channel and stuff. So at some point, it'll be a while, there'll be just an individual video of you talking at this up. Sweet. Yeah, good meeting you, man. There we go, get some nice wraps. Can't go wrong with wraps. Now, with any luck at all, Bill Stull is watching this. He'll appreciate this. He's one of the big wrap guys in the vintage snowmobile space. Yeah, they've got a great turnout for this. For guys putting on the first time putting on a vintage snowmobile show, this is really impressive. And by the way, this show is put on by the nice folks at the Kingdom Grill. That's an excellent restaurant. My girlfriend and I had dinner there last weekend, had an excellent time, excellent meal. And that yurt, that tent out there, apparently it's got a big banquet table in there and a wood stove, and you can rent that and have a meal in there with the kind of a family event or something. Looks like a blizzard. The colors are a little different, but it looks like a blizzard to me, like an old 6500. I like that, those graphics and the paint and the colors and stuff. Something tells me this has been on the track. Hey there, Blaine Kodasek and Joe Staff. Sorry, I'm not reading all the comments that are coming on. It's all I can do here to kind of... Here we go. This might be Paul Belfay, that Elite. I know he's got one. And he's here. But I don't know if that's his. It doesn't look like him driving it. But I caught up with Paul Belfay earlier. And he's agreed to talk to us at some point during the show. You've probably seen him on my videos. He's a regular on Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. He's got an impressive collection, and he's always good at talking up his sleds. He's always got really good information about them. These Dauphins are pretty rare, as are these Speedways, for that matter. Now, what is this? Quebec. I don't know that I've ever seen one of these. Let's go in for a closer look here. We're kind of in the shade here with that engine. I was hoping to get a close-up on that. Maybe if I put my hand over it now. Hey, Rick White. Hey, Robin Richards from Labrador. I bet this thing makes some noise. How's it going?
Good, yourself?
Good.
That thing's gorgeous.
That's amazing, isn't it? Those are rare, too. Is that yours, or do you know who owns it?
No. You're Mike?
Yeah, Vintage Snowmobile Lovers.
Yes, okay.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Let me give you a business card.
I'm Todd.
Cool.
We own the Kingdom Grill.
Do you mind if I put you on camera?
No. That's
in fact, it's a good opportunity to do a shameless plug. Hey, folks, we got 100 and we'll get 96 viewers watching live. Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. This is the owner of the Kingdom Grill. These are the folks putting this on.
Yeah. Good stuff. Good turnout. A lot of cool stuff. Beautiful stuff. I don't know, man. It's a beautiful day.
Yeah.
A little bit of snow. Couldn't ask for better.
Definitely. And especially for a first-time show, this is an incredible turnout,
with
exhibitors and spectators.
We're learning a lot in a big hurry, but hopefully next year it's bigger and better and a little more organized. But I don't know. Awesome people, too, because everybody helps.
Yeah, for sure.
But beautiful day, man.
You want to talk up the restaurant? I know there's a... My girlfriend and I had dinner here last weekend, and they told us on the way out that you've got a banquet table in that tent.
Yes. Yeah, that's the yurt. Actually, that's the other owner right there.
Okay, yes. Nice.
She's more fun to look at than me.
Cool, yeah. We've got 101 viewers right now live.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, next time you do one of these, be in touch with me. We'll help you pre-promote it on the front end, you know, because
Okay. Yeah,
I've got the largest community of vintage snowmobile enthusiasts anywhere.
Yeah.
Over 50,000 fans.
Hey, what?
How are you doing?
Good.
Hey, Jesse, you're live on Facebook.
Oh, how are you doing?
Nice to meet you.
So excited. The sun came out, the snow came down last night, and the wind's dying down a little. This is awesome.
Yeah, an amazing turnout.
Awesome. I'm so excited. We were thinking maybe a dozen sleds, maybe a couple dozen, not so much.
Yeah, this is impressive.
We're excited.
Definitely.
And next year it'll be even better.
Yeah, for sure. Especially second time around, once it's established, people are aware of it.
Trial and error, and we're ready to go.
Definitely.
This is awesome.
Now I'm going to get a close-up on your Kingdom Grill.
Oh,
I'm not getting weird or anything. And this is that Kingdom Grill right behind us. You want to talk up the grill and the menu and the banquet table in the tent?
Would you mind if I just run some more slips? We're running out of room.
Not at all. Go ahead.
Yeah. Then I'll be back.
Sure, I'll be right here. Oh, Roberto, this is an Island Pond, Vermont. Frijola Tierra. Tell me if I butchered that, Roberto. I hope I got that right. I love these early 70s TNTs with this color scheme. 440 free air.
That's on.
Now this Panther belongs to Steve Dickinson. He's here and he's going to talk them up at some point during the day. And he was telling me about this sled that he got with this crazy print, this leopard skin print. And if you've got a cat, you've got to have the purple power loop. It's a crime not to. This is also Steve Dickinson's sled. He's from Berlin, New Hampshire. He is a cat collector extraordinaire. If you like cat, this is the guy, man. He finds them rare and original. And this might be Paul Belfay's sled. Steve was telling me that Paul bought an SRV. Let's take a look here and see if this is Paul Belfay's sled. 1985, only 250 miles on this sled. Paul Belfay also has an impressive collection. And I spoke with him earlier, and he's agreed to talk up his sleds. So at some point we'll circle back here and talk these up. Is this Paul's too? This is not. Alan Pike.
That's a nice turnout today, didn't they?
This is amazing. Is that Steve Bushway under there?
That is.
Hey, you mind if I put you on camera?
I don't care.
Hey, Steve. How you doing, man? We've got 109 people watching live on Facebook.
There you go.
Good seeing you, man.
Yeah, good
to
see you.
Did you bring some Yamahas today?
I did. I brought my little one.
Nice. You want to talk it up?
Anywhere.
Okay. All right. Well, this is amazing. This is a hell of a turnout for a first show. This is amazing.
And neat stuff.
Yes. Really good mix of different kinds of sleds and
some of the stuff you wouldn't even I haven't seen before.
Yeah, same here, like that little Quebec.
Well, that,
I think I've heard of those, but I've never seen
yeah,
one.
That's anyway, that's Steve Beckett. Yeah.
Steve Beckett?
Yeah, it's him. And he's just got stuff.
Sure.
He goes to Canada and gets stuff.
Oh, the old rare stuff out of Quebec?
That, yeah, that's what he gets.
Nice.
He knows his stuff. He's got his He does that.
That's cool. Are those three sleds his, the Dolphin and the Speedway?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, there's some nice examples.
Yeah.
Now, was Speedway made in Quebec, do you know?
I don't remember where that one was made. It seems like that was made in Vermont.
Okay, yeah. Because I think Dolphin was made in Quebec, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Very cool.
He's got some neat stuff.
Yeah.
He's got some neat stuff.
It was Beckett, you said? What was his first name?
Steve.
Steve Beckett, yeah.
I can't even tell you where to pick him out.
Yeah, I wonder who's where. I'd like to catch up with him, get some comments. And
see him down there. Nice guy. I mean, he's... I don't see him down there.
Make sure you have a ton of fun. Make sure you buy raffle tickets. Make
hope
sure
we haven't. Check out the merchandise. It's quite a show here.
Yeah, I am really impressed. Definitely. And they get some trophies over here too, huh?
Yeah.
Sweet. And
cash prizes.
Nice.
Stop.
Now, where do you come in from, Steve? Where do you come in from?
I come from Lisbon, Lyman, New Hampshire.
Okay, yeah.
About a 60-mile hike.
Sure. Nice. Yeah, that was a bummer. The Lancaster show was canceled and the Washington show, huh?
Yeah.
I really look forward to those.
I like the Washington.
Me too.
We did the ride down there, Franconia Notch, last weekend.
How was that? Was that good?
Yeah.
Nice.
A little less on participation. There were probably 100 of us.
Yeah.
But it was good. Cold.
Nice.
Sleds ran good. We had a blast.
Sweet.
Again.
Now, would you say the low participation was COVID or the weather or just question mark? A
combination of everything,
sure.
I think. They were, nobody traveled. The pub was going to have a cookout. Because of COVID, they pulled on that. Not that that would stop people from coming, but
sure.
They stopped that.
Yeah.
But Evelyn Bundquist's New Hampshire Museum there.
Yes.
They were responsible for it. Once they found out they were, Evelyn brought up hot dogs and hamburgers. She had one of them cat cutter kitchens.
Oh wow, yeah.
Up on top.
Nice.
I don't know how long she cooked, but there was a line.
That's cool. Yeah, you're right. They do the food for a lot of events, those guys.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So we had it was a good turnout.
Yep.
Lots of nice sleds.
Yeah.
I didn't see a lot of old bombers.
Yeah.
There was a few, but most of them were, I mean, all did his.
Stuff like oh, he brought these?
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess he just got this SRV, huh?
Yeah.
In the last year?
Well, just recently.
Yeah.
I got like a couple hundred miles on
That's amazing, huh? That's a great shape.
Yeah. He rode that. Brought that. His wife was riding, I can't remember what it was. Yeah. XL3, I think.
What was it?
Bravo. XL3 or
Bravo? Bravo. XL, yes, yeah.
Yeah. She was riding that, so they brought those three.
Sweet.
There was a lot of nice stuff. Yeah.
Sweet. I'll have to go to that next time.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Cool, you got to go. It's worth going to.
Nice.
20-mile ride, give or take. It's 9 miles one way.
Yeah. Yeah, in a lot of ways, that's probably more fun than a traditional show because you're riding them, you know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they're going to run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool.
I ran my GTX. My daughter and I ran the GTX.
Yeah, yeah.
We had a good time. She liked it.
Good. Cool deal.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, well, good seeing you, Steve.
Take it easy.
All right, man. So these are the trophies they'll be giving out later.
It's your day.
I'm playing the lottery.
It's your day today.
Oh, they've got some nice shirts. They've got refreshments and food here. Hi. How are you today? So Max, one of the organizers of this, he's the guy behind Snow Traveler Apparel. And I think I'm gonna move away from these speakers because it's a bit of a contest for audio. They're like that. Any King Cats? I have not seen one yet, but I've not seen everything. Hey there, Merle and Joseph. Hey, how's it going, Brad?
How you doing?
Good, nice to see you, man. Let's give you a fist bump. Give you a fist bump.
There COVID we go. Handshake.
There we go. Oh, yeah, COVID handshake. You got any sleds here today?
423 at Skidoo.
Oh, nice. We're live with 98 people watching. Do you want to talk it up? No? Okay. That's a sweet example, though, the free air.
Yep. Yeah, it'll get kind of dirty coming up here, but...
Oh, yeah.
On the back of an open trailer.
Take it across the ice.
Oh, yeah. You have to clean it up once you get it here, probably. Sure. Cool.
This is a good turnout.
Yeah, especially for a first show, man. This is really impressive.
Really good.
Yeah. Good deal. You mind if I have you on camera? All right, cool. This is our buddy Brad. He's a big player here in the East with snowmobile events. You organized the races over in Lisbon, right? Nice. Did they have that this year? Oh, nice. Sweet. Good deal. Good deal.
Best one ever.
Nice. You want to talk it up a little? Or? No? Okay, I understand. No problem.
I'm not too good at that.
It's all good. Well, cool. Yeah, good seeing you, man.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah, take it easy.
I didn't know. I thought they all had them.
What's his last name again?
That might be a 69 Panther. Let's take a look here. The 69, Joey LeCaire. Cool. I thought I recognized him from earlier. Okay. I saw a guy that looked familiar to me earlier, and that was him. Now that I...
He used to be a ref for Arctic Cat back in the 70s, and he used to go around setting up all the dealerships. So, I talked to him once.
So these are Mark and Luke Bristol who brought these sleds. They've been on the podcast before. What do we got coming through here? Thank you. Alan Gibo's here. Excellent. Douglas Gray. Are these yours? Oh, nice to meet you. Douglas, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice to meet you. I'm Mike with Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. Let me give you my card. We're live right now on Facebook with 103 viewers.
Cool.
Do you feel like talking this up?
Cool.
Cool, yeah. Just, you know, my name is Doug. And
79 Pantera. It's all original. 1,800 miles.
Nice.
Ride it all the time.
It's
not,
wonderful.
It's not a show sled. I just put 104 miles on it Monday.
Nice. You get the matching suits, the his and her suits.
Yep.
Gotta love it.
Yeah. I got a little bit of an addiction problem.
Yeah, I hear that. You're not alone, my friend.
I got a 76 at home. I need to finish getting ready. And a 73 Cheeto.
Nice. And this is the missus. You got anything you want to say? Or?
Great to be here.
Good deal. Having a good time?
Yeah.
Sweet.
She has fun chasing me on this.
See what?
She has fun chasing me on this.
Oh, I bet. Yeah. Nice. I want to try just get some shots. Now you've got what, matching bags and stuff?
Oh, they're not matching. They're just mainly I got them for the sticker, all the old patches.
Oh yeah.
A bunch of old vintage patches.
Let me come around. Yeah, those were the best back in the day. All the patches and stickers and stuff.
Yeah.
The cat was here. Yeah. Turpentine cat. Let me get. I'm getting shadow on it here. There we go.
Cool cat.
Yeah. Now you're talking. Very cool. Yeah, those patches were so much fun back in the day, weren't they?
Yeah.
That's amazing. What's that?
I found this matching helmet with all
the... Oh, look at that. That metal flake. That's amazing. Beautiful paintwork on that.
Yeah. I guess I'm going to get it relined so I can actually wear it.
Sure. Yeah.
Nice spray helmet.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, this is nice, man.
Yeah, we're all original.
Got the trail riders going through. Go ahead, I'm sorry, all original?
Yeah, I bought it. Bought it on eBay. Came from Michigan.
Yeah. Now, where are you from?
Derby Line.
Oh, Derby Line. No yeah. kidding, I am too.
Yeah.
Wow.
I think you came into the Modern Furniture one day.
Oh, yeah, yeah, we met a couple years ago. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool, yeah, it's good to see you again, man.
Yeah, I'm glad they're having a local show.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Nice. I used to go down to the one down in Bethel, but when I live down that way.
Yeah.
Kind of glad to see them do one around here.
Totally.
If they do it back next year, I'll have more than this one. Yeah.
Definitely.
Get my
76. We'll have to do some video at your place. Do you have like a man cave with sleds and stuff?
I don't know if I call it. I just got a little shop I work in. But
yeah.
I only fit one at a time in there.
Sure.
Fortunately.
Or when it gets a little warmer, is it possible like to pull them out and we'll talk them up?
Sure, cool.
Since we're in the same town, you know what
yeah.
I'm saying? Like, we'll just figure out a time to come over and stuff.
Yeah, my 76 is cool. It's got the free air and it's got a rear gas tank.
Oh, no kidding.
That was the first year of this body style, was 76.
Yeah.
This was the last year.
79, I think?
79, this yeah. one, yeah. I've got a couple other chassis. What I'd really like to do in time is fix up the other ones. And it ran for 4 years, so if I put the decals on that matched each year.
Yes, yeah.
So I'd have, like, show them on of all four.
That'd be amazing.
They wouldn't
have Pantera collection.
All 76s, but unless people really knew a lot about it, they wouldn't, you know,
true, yeah.
tell the difference.
Yeah, but it's still a nice way to see all the different, the lineage of it.
Yeah. 78 and 79 don't look too much different. 77
right, right.
had a complete different decal package on it.
Sure.
78
and
79 was when they did this wood grain seal.
Yes, yeah. I remember when that came out. I thought that was awfully sharp when that came out.
Yeah,
I mean, it still is, you know. But it was different, especially the orange trim and everything and the and the fancy lettering, you know. That's cool.
It goes plenty fast enough for what it is.
Yeah, sweet. In its day, that was probably the ultimate trail sled.
No, they called them the Cadillacs.
Yes.
Cadillac.
Cadillac. I remember that, yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, they were.
Cool deal. Well, yeah, it was good seeing you. Are you on Facebook?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll look for you on Facebook.
Okay.
Cool deal. Good deal. Yeah, good talking. I want to catch up with Alan Gibo over here. That's his sled right there, I think.
That's sweet.
Yeah.
My dad's got a 71 Lynx, already had it, and my stepsister has it. I'm trying to get it away from him.
Yeah.
It's all restored.
Yeah.
I'd love to have it. Just a little 292 single, but.
Sure. Do you think she'd give that up at some point, or?
I I worked on her a little bit, but I gotta try harder, I guess.
Sure.
I'd like to have
just keep putting $100 bills down until she says okay.
I got a 73 Cheetah at home too.
Oh, I'd like to see that.
Yeah. It looks just like that 400 over there.
Oh yes, yeah.
But it's a 340.
Nice.
But that's been sitting for years, so I gotta just go through it. The motor is free, so hopefully it ran when they parked it.
Yeah. Sweet deal. Well, cool. Yeah, good seeing you guys. Take it easy. Fist bump.
Hopefully,
nice meeting you guys.
Hopefully this comes back next year.
Yeah, this is a good show. Good location, too.
Yeah, I think it will. I think it'll catch on.
Yeah, if they have this good of a turnout for their first one, it can only get better from here, I think.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, this
did they do the one down near Montpelier this year?
Oh, the Washington? No, it was canceled. That's a bummer, too, because that's a good show.
Yeah.
That's
a lot of fun. Well, I used to go to the one in Bethel, the Vintage Rendezvous.
Yeah.
They had that for quite a few years. And that used to be nice, because they always had an area where they had a field you could bomb around on. And
yeah, that's fun about the Washington show.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, it's not just sit here and look at them.
Yeah.
They had a place where you could ride them around. I was actually hoping the weather held up. We were going to ride from Derby Line to the show.
Oh, that'd be cool.
After that meltdown there, I was like, man, I don't
Yeah,
know
the trails are probably pretty spotty. Yeah.
Yeah, I was out here yesterday and I saw how bare it was right here in town. So
yeah.
We'll just trailer it.
But. Yeah, that's probably a safer bet. Yeah, you don't want to bang up that suspension and stuff. Yeah. Cool deal. All right, yeah, good seeing you guys. Take it easy. We'll be in touch. Dan Moore, 1963 Polaris experimental sled. Now I've met him at other shows too, and I talked to him earlier. He said he'd agree to talk up some of his sleds. I think this is his too. These all four of these. I don't know about that Panther, but. Yeah, this is Dan Moore's, who's Alan Gibo, okay. And that's him over there. He's talking to somebody, but I want to catch up with him. That's Dan Moore's also, okay. Tyler Tyrell. Cut in front of you real quick. Excuse me. Thanks. These TXs were quite the sleds back in the day. We had a 76 250 TX when I was a kid. Looked pretty much just like this. I don't know if this is a 76 or 77. I'm going to look on the front. Ours looked pretty much like this. Let's see. 76, yeah, 76. Dave DeSorda. Great sleds, huh?
Oh, yeah. I got one of these on the restore. I told you that.
Oh, yeah. And you're right here in Island Pond, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you want to do some video sometime? Like, I'll come
did.
Over?
No, but like, Harley over there, right?
But like, come over to the house and talk up all your sleds and stuff?
Yeah, no matter.
Cool. Or even on your cell phone.
Yeah.
Because I do a live podcast every week, and I bring people on their cell phones. Yeah.
Is that you?
Yeah.
I don't know how to fucking even get on that fucking thing.
Oh, really?
I need my kid or something, dude.
Oh, to get on Facebook?
No, I don't. I get on Facebook, but I don't know how to go on a podcast.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, your kids could probably help you.
Reception, got a tin roof on the house.
Oh, no. Do you have Wi-Fi?
Oh, no.
No?
shut that off yet.
Yeah, it's been running.
Probably can't.
Yeah.
Broke the recoil, right?
Yeah, exactly. Crazy. Cool deal.
Yep.
Yeah, look for me on Facebook.
I love this stuff, man. You got
me
old
too.
Sleds too?
Just one sled. It's not modern or vintage. It's a 92 Ski-Doo Safari.
Uh-huh.
That's all I've got right now, but I love vintage stuff.
92 is fucking old.
Yeah, old enough. Yeah. It's almost 30 years old. Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, I like the older ones too. But
yeah.
I really, since I've been doing this, I'd rather fool with these than ride my 2018.
Yeah. What do you have for the 18?
Rush.
Oh, yeah, Polaris.
Rush, yeah.
Sweet.
Axis 600. Goes great.
How do you like that suspension? Nice. I've heard good things about that.
I got it dialed in perfectly too, man.
Nice.
Got dualies on the front of it.
Yeah.
Yep. A little tough getting it off the concrete and stuff, but grip from its steers, boy. It steers right.
Nice.
Heard about the car.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of good things about that.
I didn't even bother registering them this year.
Oh, yeah, with the trails and the shape they're in.
Well, not bad. It's remodeling my house.
Yeah, it's expensive. Between the insurance and the VAS and the registration. Yeah.
Lumber, I spent it on my house, you know?
Yeah.
I just reframing it, put a new bathroom in, put a new kitchen in.
Yeah.
A whole lot of shit new on Facebook.
Yeah.
Use cabinets, use vanity. I mean, I bought a brand new
shower.
Save
some money.
Unit, you know? Saves tons of
good.
Cabinets for $200, 18 cabinets.
That's
I only put nine in my kitchen. I got the other ones in the garage, you know?
Yeah.
Put them up on the wall and keep on this shit. Built a new garage. Yeah, I should have just raised it up a little higher than where I set it up. Get a little water in there. But I go with the bucket and scoop off the snow that comes off the roof.
Sure.
So far, so good. But that last snow, boy, I had 6 inches of water in between my garages, you know.
Oh, geez.
They're all full.
Yeah.
They're all full of shit.
Yeah.
Not shit toys, you know. I got a quad, a Massey Ferguson tractor. I got three old snowmobiles in there.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of stuff.
I built a six and a half foot loft, because I don't need 6 foot.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like 4 foot off the wall, all the way down the side of the building with a staircase going up, so I can store stuff up there and everything. So.
Nice. Gets it off the floor.
So it's 32 by 24.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Cool.
I should have went bigger.
Yeah.
Whenever you grill in the garage, I think you're going to at least do it time and a half what you're thinking.
It's true. You always fill it up. Yeah.
Yep.
It's true.
When I got four sleds in my my other garage, my workshop, and I got 3-5 sleds and bag of parts and a cutter in my 4-place trailer.
Yeah, yeah.
My 2-place is empty, but that's where I put my modern ones. I got an 06 Ski-Doo too.
Yeah, yeah.
So I keep them in the trailer all summer.
Sweet. Well, cool. I've got this thing going live here, so I'm going to keep walking around.
Yeah,
but yeah, we'll catch up with you, man.
Yep. All
right. Good deal.
Thank you. What's your name again?
Mike. Mike LaPierre, yeah.
Mike LaPierre?
Yeah. You know the paint store in Newport? That was my uncle that used to own that.
Oh, you still do work at a paint stuff?
No, I don't do that at all. That was my uncle that used to own that. But he and my cousins used to do that, but he sold. He's retired now.
Paint work is expensive. I told you that earlier. $1,000 for each.
It is.
Well,
yeah.
Enjoy, man.
Yeah, nice seeing you, man.
Film somebody else.
Definitely.
You hear my mouth about it.
What is that? Bedard? Is it you, Ed? Nice. We had one just like that when I was a kid.
Hey, how
you doing? We're live right now on Facebook with 94 people watching. Do you want to talk it up? Just, you know, my name is, and talk it up.
My name is Ed Bedard. This is my 72 Hard to Catch Cheetah, 440. Bought it from a guy. He had it just for his kids to ride around, and his kids are growing up, so he wanted to sell it. Picked it up, cleaned it up, and that's how she sits. Totally original.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had one exactly like that when I was a kid.
Yes.
That's amazing. How long do you say you've had it?
I've had it for 3 years now.
3 years.
Right.
Still not totally finished, but she's usable.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
So, did you ride over it?
Yeah, that 440 will get up and go, too.
Yeah, she's not quiet either.
No, they had a nice exhaust note.
They did.
The Kawasaki engine.
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing. Wow, that's in really nice shape. That's cool. Very cool. You have other sleds here too, or
nope, just this one. I just started collecting them all. I have three more in the barn that I'm going through one at a time. This was the first one that I did.
Yeah, nice.
I have a 72 Panther that I'm working on now. I also have a 72 Articap Puma and that Colt.
Yeah,
Polaris Colt.
Sweet. So 72 is your year, or is that a coincidence?
No, it's kind of a coincidence, but I love the body style of these. So
yeah, because they only made this one year.
There's more years of the Cheetah.
But I mean, of this body style.
Yes. Yep.
The Cheetah in this body style, yeah.
Yep. 73 had changed.
Yes, yeah.
Articat was doing some funny things back then.
They were.
Yeah.
Definitely. Where are you based out of?
I live in Bloomfield, Enfield, Connecticut, and I have a house here in Island Pond.
Sweet, yeah. Good deal.
Enough snow there.
Good deal. Did I give you a business card yet?
No, sir.
Let me give you one. Yeah, I'm on Facebook, Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. Do a live podcast every Thursday night.
Nice.
There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah, do look for us.
I will.
In fact, this is going live on there right now.
Awesome.
It's the largest community of vintage snowmobile enthusiasts anywhere. It's got over 50,000 fans.
Yep. I just got my son into it. He doesn't want to collect Articap because I do, so we just picked up that John Deere liquefier.
Oh, that's it?
Monday night we picked that up.
Sweet.
The only thing we did last night is got it going. We haven't touched it yet or cleaned it up, so that's a work in progress itself.
Nice. That's a nice example, though. That'll clean up nice. That's not going to need much.
Nope.
That's cool. Now, is he here to talk that up, or do you want to talk it up?
Right there. Went over, Nate.
How's it going? Yeah, we're live on Facebook. You feel like talking up your liquefier?
Yeah, I mean, I just bought it earlier this week. We haven't had a chance to do anything to it. Kind of just clean it up, clean the carbs, and then, in the future, I want to find new graphics for it, give it a nice paint job, need a new seat, and then it's going to be good.
Sweet.
I want a nice sled I can ride.
Yeah, for sure. That'll be it, yeah.
Yeah.
What year is this?
It's an 80.
80, yeah.
It's got a 440 Cowie, liquid cooled.
Yeah.
It's, I bought it in Connecticut. Guy had it sitting in his barn for like 20 years.
Yeah.
He's a farmer. He owned all John Deere equipment. So, he always loved John Deere sleds, but he said he hasn't used it, so he wanted to sell it. So now my plan is to restore it.
Sweet. Nice. I want to get around the front side of it. Oh, there's a lot of people over there. I don't know. I'm going to try anyway. Let's see. Yeah, I can get a good angle here. There we go. Yeah, that's a sharp looking sled, huh?
Yeah, they're pretty interesting looking.
Yeah. Sweet. What part of Connecticut are you guys from?
We're from Enfield.
Enfield, yeah?
Yeah, right on the Mass line.
Yes, yeah. So you probably come right up 91, huh?
Yep, right up 91.
Good. That makes it easy.
Really?
Get up here.
Nice, easy drive.
Good. Yeah, and the Derby Club's got their groomer out. Cool deal, man. Yeah, well, nice meeting you, Nate.
You too. Thank you.
If you're watching, I wonder what's going on. I'm just trying to get situated here. I want to find a cable to plug my camera in for battery power. I don't want this thing dying on me. Well, things are going good here. The other concern I have is I may at some point run out of signal with a network. I may use up all my data, but we'll see. What you got here?
Glasses.
Oh, sweet. Thanks, man. Yeah, he gave me some cool glasses with a Ski-Doo theme. A guy with a Ski-Doo jacket gave me some Ski-Doo. Oh, Kingdom Grill, yeah. Sweet. Yeah, I'm trying to find my charging cable. I want to plug this thing in. Alan Jebo, How you doing, my friend? Nice to see you.
You too, man.
I see you got some cats over here, huh?
Got a couple. One in the trailer.
Nice. Do you mind being on camera?
Nah.
We're live right now.
Oh, we're live right now?
Yeah. In writhing color.
Yeah.
So, how you been?
Hanging in there.
Good. Oh, no. Did you hurt your foot?
Yeah. I'm going to wear this for a while. See if it helps.
Wow. Did you have like a fall or something? Or just random aches and pains? Or?
Yeah. I nursed it about a year and a half, hoping it'd get better, but it didn't.
Oh, no.
I'll go see a doctor.
Yeah. Do you feel like talking up your sleds?
Yeah, if you want. There's
sure.
A lot to say.
Yeah, here we go. I'm bumbling around here trying to find a charging cable so I don't run out of juice on this phone, but I thought I brought one with me, but I don't think I did.
Uh-oh.
I mean, I've got one in the car, but I thought I stuck one in one of my pockets. But yeah, do you want to walk over and...
They're having shows. Only been like two this year.
Yeah, I know. That was a bummer about Washington and Lancaster. Do you go to the Lancaster show?
No, I've never been to that one.
No?
I like the other one, though.
The Washington. That's a great show.
Like that,
yeah.
Man.
This was yours right here, right? Cool. Yeah, let's get in close and
do the 68 of poles.
Wow, you could eat out of that. That's amazing. That is nice. Sweet. Gotta love these leopard skin seats, man.
Yeah.
The rear tank.
Nice electric battery box.
What's that now?
A electric battery box.
Oh, is that a battery box?
Yeah.
Wow, now where's the fuel? Is it up on the gas can?
Yep.
The detachable gas can? That's cool. That was a great idea. I'm surprised more companies didn't do that. Detachable like that?
Yeah. They don't carry a whole lot, but easy to get in and out.
Yeah. And you had another sled here too, right? All right. Cool, yeah. Do you want to go over and... Here we go. So what are we looking at here?
71 Lynx 303 with a Wankel.
Nice.
I just finished it a few weeks ago.
That is amazing. Oh, Glenn, the show ends at 3. Island Pond, Vermont. I've got people asking me on here where and when. And... Wow. Yeah, that's amazing. So what did this need in the way of restoration? Was it just cleaning it up, or did you have to redo anything? Or
I completely disassembled it.
Yeah?
Had the bulkhead fabricated, and I took the tunnel off and just took it all apart.
Yeah?
A number of years ago, I finally said I got to put it back together. Had the hood painted and the new windshield, and the gas tank, console.
Easy. Yeah.
Beautiful.
That's amazing.
Stuff.
That really pops too. I mean, the shine, it shines and the leopard skin pops, you know, it's just really, really sharp sled.
It starts good too.
Oh, nice. Do you feel like firing it up?
I can fire it up.
Cool, yeah, I'll switch sides with you here.
Not as loud as his over there though.
Yeah, yeah, those vertical pipes are crazy. Yeah, it purrs nice. Purrs like a cat should. That's amazing. Cool. Nice. Yeah, thank you, Alan. Oh, you got the shirt and everything.
Yeah.
Nice. You do like Superman for me. Nice. That's cool. That's cool. Now you got to go out and fight crime.
I think I got to draw a line here.
Yeah, exactly. Every man has his limits. Yeah. I'm too old for that, too.
Yeah. I just know better.
Yeah. Hey, do you mind holding this for a minute? I want to zip my jacket up.
Okay.
Yeah, in the upper left-hand corner, you see the view count. See how many people are watching live.
Huh, they got this live, huh?
Yeah.
You got this pretty well figured out, don't you?
I'm getting there. It gets a little better every year. Yeah, I've been doing it long enough. Yep. Yeah, thanks, man.
Good that you do it.
Yeah. Did I give you a business card?
Yeah, I think you did.
Probably have in the past. You would like another one? Or?
I think I got one still. Right ahead.
Okay. Because I'm doing a podcast now every Thursday night, live every Thursday night. On Facebook, Vintage Snowmobile Lovers.
Oh, cool.
And it airs in 8 different places. So if you jump on Facebook or YouTube and just search Vintage Snowmobile Podcast, it'll come up in 8 different places.
Yeah. Should be able to find it.
Yeah, totally.
I'm not very good at that thing, the computer, no.
Sure.
But we'll try it, see what happens.
Yeah, for sure. Are you on Facebook? Do you have a profile?
I'm on there, but I'm not very good at navigating it.
No? Okay, I'll have to give you a friend request sometime.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
And refresh my memory, where are you based out of?
Moncton.
Moncton, that's right. Moncton, Vermont, yeah. What kind of ride is that to get here?
3 hours.
3 hours, wow, that's a ride.
I didn't know how long it was going to take me, so I left home at 5. I was here at like 8:30.
Wow.
So I had to sit around for a while before they...
Sure.
I was here before the porta potty got here.
Oh, really? Wow. Better to be early than late, I guess.
True.
Excuse me.
Oh. That's pretty nice out now.
Yeah, it's getting nice, definitely.
This morning it was kind of not so nice.
Yeah. Sweet.
Yeah, not a nice place here.
Yeah, for sure. And especially for a first show, an amazing turnout.
Yeah.
It's really impressive.
I didn't know about it until somebody down home told me about it.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess they just started planning it a few weeks ago. It's not like it's been planned for a long time. But I got to give them credit, man, for just whipping it together in a few weeks. This is amazing.
Well, a lot of people, you know, are chomping at the bit to go to a show, you know. We haven't had any.
How are
you doing? Hi, how are you?
Good.
Good.
Some of these had to be hard to ride, huh?
Yeah, definitely. Especially the old bogeys.
Yeah.
Do you have sleds here?
No, I don't.
No?
No.
Let me give you a business card. I'm on Facebook.
I don't. Oh, yeah, okay.
I'm on, you get on Facebook?
For the hotel, yeah.
Oh, no, this is your hotel over here?
I'm the bar manager.
Oh, nice. Yeah, Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. It's the largest community of vintage snowmobile enthusiasts anywhere, okay. Facebook or otherwise, over 50,000 fans.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Cool.
Cool. And what was your name?
Greg.
Greg, nice meeting you, Greg.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah. Cool deal.
So I've been talking to a guy from Rochester.
Good to see you, Al.
We'll see
you. Take care. Joey? Hey, Mike with Vintage Snowmobile Lovers. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you.
Nice to see you. Sorry to catch you with your mouthful.
I'm breaking it up on
them. We can give you a mouthful, too.
Oh, no, thanks.
Stone.
Oh, they look amazing.
Really
I'm diabetic, though. I can't be eating that. But thank you, though.
Oh, you're welcome.
I appreciate the offer.
Yeah.
Do you have sleds here, Joey?
Yeah.
Nice. Do you feel like talking it up? We're on Facebook Live with 76 people watching. Give you a minute to it. Yeah, sure. I heard you sold the racetrack, huh?
I did.
Yeah?
Yep.
Nice. So you're retiring, or are you going to sell the dealership too? Or
no.
No?
No. No, I'm going back racing powered now.
Oh, nice, yeah. Do you mind if I have you on camera?
I don't mind.
Okay. Yeah, give you a sec. Yeah, definitely. Sorry. Yeah, so that's Joey LaCare. He owns LaCare's, he's got a Polaris dealership over in, near Montpelier. I don't know if it's Montpelier or Barrie, but in that area. He's going to come over here in a minute. He's going to talk to us about his sled. Yeah, that's a sweet example. And I see he's got the matching suit. Thank you. this Puma. Did you have a minute to talk these up?
I can if you'd like me to.
Yeah, if you don't mind. This is your dad's sled, right?
Yeah, that one's... Have him talk his sled up.
Oh, this is your dad?
One. Yeah!
Oh, yeah. How's it going, Mark?
There you go. See, have him do it. Mike. I've done him before.
What am I doing?
I'm Mike with Vintage Snowmobile Lovers.
How
nice to
you?
Meet you. He's been on my podcast. I don't know if you heard any about that or not.
Yeah, but... I don't watch it. I don't like it.
You disowned him?
Yeah, disowned him.
Crazy. Hey, when that happens.
Yeah. He wants you to talk about your sled there. You get to talk about your sled.
I've done it. We're live with 80 people watching.
We can start it at the end.
Well, we can start it at the end.
So, what do you want to know?
So, basically, you know, my name is Mark Bristol. This is my 71 Puma, and just kind of talk it up like you're telling a friend about it.
Okay. Hi, my name is Mark Bristol. I live in Kirby, Vermont. This is my 71 Puma Z. So, it's got a Kawasaki engine.
Nice.
It has dual carb, dual 34 millimeter carbs, and it has crossover stingers. It's actually, there's only 96 of them made.
96? Yep. Wow, this is very rare.
Well, they're made for racing.
That's an amazing shape, too.
Yep. You like to hear it run?
Please. Here we go. Yeah, I like that crackle. Sweet, yeah, thank you, Luke. Very cool.
That yeah, yeah, it does sound good.
That sounds amazing, yeah. That crackle.
I don't like that, Brian.
I love it.
They're all about loud stuff there. Don't take it.
I've never even got...
Here's Joey. Yeah, cool. I appreciate it, man. Yep. I was going to catch up with him.
Yep.
Cool.
I had to go pee.
Oh, I understand. No problem at all. And you're welcome to talk at the dealership, too. We're on Facebook Live with 79 people watching. And I was just talking about your dealership. Is it Barrie or Montpelier? Where?
East Montpelier.
East Montpelier.
Yes. Yeah.
And that's Polaris Snowmobiles. And what else have you got over there?
We're a boat dealer. We sell craft pontoons, free craft, fishing, ski boats. We repair any boat, all motors, any kind of snowmobile.
Yeah. Nice. That's a nice dealership.
Yeah. I started in 1961 and still going.
61?
1961.
Wow. Yeah. That's what, 60 years?
Yeah.
Is my math right on that?
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, and this is the sled you brought. Do you feel like talking that up?
I've
69
had,
Panther?
Yeah, it's 69 Panther, 440 Hurst, electric start.
Yeah.
It was a one owner sled. Nice little sled.
Yeah. That's really nice. We had a 69 just like that when I was a kid.
Yeah.
This is in better shape than ours ever was.
Yeah, Panther was a pretty popular brand.
Yeah.
This is a nice showing here today. They're doing a good job.
Seriously, yeah. I'm really impressed. For a first-time show,
yeah,
this is amazing.
No entry fee. Everything's free. They're giving away coffee and sunglasses. Kingdom Cat here in Island Pond.
Sure. And the Kingdom Grill. Sure. Yeah, that's amazing. It's funny, we had one of these like this when I was a kid, and it was a tank. I don't know what my dad was thinking one day, but he was riding, we had a big long snowbank, he was riding along the top of it, and at one point it just got...
Teetered and fell over?
Yeah, so he just stepped off it. It rolled two complete revolutions, landed upright, engine never skipped a beat. All he had to do was get behind the windshield, just push it up, and he rode off into the sunset.
Yeah.
But a modern sled today would never, they would destroy it, I'm sure.
Oh, I'm sure it would, yeah.
Well, and is this your cheetah? Or?
No, it's a friend of mine, Dave Buska.
Okay, yeah.
From Plainfield. Yeah, that's his cheetah.
That's a nice example, too.
That's a nice sled, yeah.
Cool. Yeah, well, good seeing you again, Joey.
Hey,
I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Let me give you a business card.
Yes.
I've got a weekly podcast now on Facebook every Thursday night.
Oh, yeah. I've got you. On my desk.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
I was in the dealership a few, 3 years ago.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's Lucas Bristol and his Thunderjet. Cool deal. Oh, there he is. Is that Max in the blue over there?
Yes, it is.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I'd like to talk to him.
Come on back.
All right, cool. Yeah, I'll come around this side. Hey. Nice to see you, man. This is an excellent show, man.
Oh, thank you. I don't know. So, like I said on the podcast,
we're live right now.
Hey, everybody! Judging is going to be kind of lax this year. Next year, given this turnout, next year we'll definitely do division and classes. So, we'll get it popping for next year. Hey, this is awesome.
Yeah.
What a turnout.
These are amazing. Totally.
Exactly.
Here we go. Awesome. Yeah, we should have better audio now if you wanted to talk it up.
Yeah, welcome to the show. This is the first annual Island Pond Vintage Snowmobile Show. My name's Max. I'm the snow traveler guy. We have an awesome turnout this year. We have, I don't know, how many sleds do you think are here?
I've been close to 70, maybe?
Yeah,
it's just a guess.
At least 50. A lot of sleds, a lot of cool old stuff. It runs the full range. We have racing sleds. We have super, super vintage stuff, so... I'm happy with it. I'm very happy with the turnout.
Yeah, absolutely.
And thank you for the confidence of it. Thank you for the podcast a couple weeks ago. I think that helped a lot.
Oh, good. I'm glad.
A lot of people.
That was a lot of fun.
That's a ton of fun.
Yeah.
That's neat.
Yeah, and the next time you do this, we'll have to do more on the front end, you know?
Yeah, oh yeah.
I'm happy to partner with you on that.
Definitely. I'll be in touch with you throughout the year leading up to it for next year.
Here's a business card.
Oh, yes. Awesome.
Grab one of these.
Awesome. Yep. Here, I'm going to give you my merch. My koozies.
Oh, sweet. Yeah, thanks, man.
No problem.
Very nice.
No problem. So, yeah, next year we'll do it all over again, and we'll do it a little bigger, a little better, we're hoping, I don't want to say anything definitively, but we're hoping next year to do something on the lake, like maybe a radar run or something like that.
That would be cool.
Yeah, exactly. I don't want to go too overboard on hyping that up, but I know the Brighton Snowmobile Club is interested in putting together a radar run. You know, no drag racing or anything wild, but...
Yeah, just like a time run.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you're racing for time, not against another machine. Yeah,
exactly. So,
nice.
This is a really cool game.
It is. And I'm going to put this merch in front of the camera here.
Oh, sure, yeah. Just hats and koozies. And I didn't bring anything up to sell for this one. But I did bring three shirts up for the raffle, so we're raffling all sorts of cool stuff off today.
Nice.
The raffle prizes are awesome, so I'm excited about that.
Nice.
We're having a ball here. So we got a good day. It was windy this morning, and I think the wind's dying down, and the sun's coming, and the weather's coming to meet us halfway, so.
Yeah, it's turning into a nice day.
Yeah.
For sure.
It really is.
And then the restaurant's opening soon, too. What time is it? Is the restaurant opened
at 11:30, so we're good.
Oh,
they're
cool.
Rolling over there, and you can get takeout food right from the raffle table, or you can go in. And,
nice.
And they're letting you do, with the COVID, they're letting you do takeout beverages, too, so you can get cocktails or whatever.
And walk around. Sweet.
Yeah, it's awesome.
How many shows can you do that?
I know.
That's amazing. That's wonderful.
We lucked out pretty big time.
That's cool.
Yeah, this is awesome. What a day it turned out.
Yeah, this is something else.
I want to take another lap. Take in some of the sleds.
Now, did you bring a sled up? You doing any riding this weekend? Or?
No, I'm not going to ride this weekend. Yeah. The legend is up the hill in Morgan at my friend Todd's house.
Yeah.
That was behind me in the video.
Yes.
I had it home for some repairs, but it stays up here year-round.
Nice, yeah.
But no, we didn't. I had to bring the truck down and bring all my gear, all the sound gear and stuff.
Yeah.
So, by the time we're packed up, cleaned up today, I don't know if we can get out for a ride.
Maybe
from their place there on the trail, we go to the warming hut. That's always a fun ride. Half an hour each way.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah.
So,
enough to get out and
exactly.
Good.
Just get on the trail.
But not so much it beats you up either.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I don't think anybody expected to get 4 or 5 inches of snow last night.
No.
You know, there's feeder trails into town that wiped out.
Yeah.
With two warm days back to back, but now it's all back in business again. So that's awesome.
Definitely.
Awesome.
Now, have you? I was just going to ask you that. Do you have a sense of how many trail riders are coming by for it? Or
no, I haven't. Kind of tally them up in my head. Since this morning, I've seen about 30, 40 people ride by.
Nice.
I see over in the corner we have some sleds parked.
Yeah.
Trail riders checking out the business. It's going to draw their attention. This is the throughway to get to.
Trail goes right through here.
Yeah, exactly. Nice.
That's
so,
good planning on that.
Yeah, so it's awesome. They're going to see all the fuss and all the cool old sleds. So hopefully we'll draw some people.
Sweet. Because I've definitely been seeing them passing through, but it didn't occur to me to count them, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
But they're definitely passing through. You're getting some traffic through here.
It's awesome. Yeah, I've been keeping a loose tally. And usually this is where everyone will park to be in town and go to the shops and restaurants and stuff. So it's not too inconvenient, but at the same time, there's a cool event going on, so.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. That makes it worth it.
This is neat. This is definitely going to be a yearly thing, and we're going to hype it up big time next year. I know. So we kind of threw this idea together about a month ago. It's only been about 30 days since.
That's impressive. To have this after 30 days of planning?
Yeah, exactly. We were sitting inside, and Todd and Jess on the table. Vintage show, and then it kind of snowballed. We were sitting around the table in there, and became real. So
that's amazing.
We were gonna. The original date was gonna be 2 weeks ago, but I think there was another one in the Pittsburgh, New Hampshire area.
Oh yes, yeah.
And that looked very well established. And I thought it'd be best not to have a direct conflict.
Totally.
They're doing it before us, you know, for years before us. I definitely don't want to step on anybody's toes. So,
yeah.
You know, maybe this second week of March weekend doesn't seem like we're in a conflict with anybody here. Time slot. So,
sweet.
Awesome. And then I want to be more present. I have my eyes on Epping. Hopefully they'll get Epping going this year.
Oh, that's a big show. Yeah.
Spot.
Sweet. Good idea.
Yeah. Go check that all out. That's gonna be a riot.
Yeah, especially with your clothing, because it's a good mix of modern and vintage people to show up for that.
Yeah.
Good deal.
Yeah. So.
Good idea.
Yeah. And then by then hopefully I'll be able to stock more. I'm just getting started, and I do a lot with online fulfillment where it's made to order. Remotely. But hopefully by then, you know, the more the business grows and I can afford it, I'll buy my own equipment and start doing things in-house.
Yeah.
It's not good things.
You want to do a shameless plug?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Dug it up, baby.
Yeah, for Snow Traveler Apparel. Snowtravelerapparel.com. I just make goofy t-shirts for people who like riding snowmobiles. T-shirts, hats, masks, all sorts of merchandise, and just a fun brand. Just, you know, wear it and
show everybody you're a snowmobiler.
Nice. So. I saw you had some nice t-shirts in the back of the SUV
there.
Yeah,
yeah.
Those are some examples?
Party sled t-shirts. Those are nice. That was top on a purple triple skidoo. And I put on my goofy suit, and my beautiful fiance did a little photo shoot with me with a mullet wig on.
Nice.
Turned it into a cartoon and made it my This Is My Party Sled t-shirt. So.
Nice.
We had fun. It's just, it's that's what it's about. It's about having fun and riding the trails.
Good deal. Cool, yeah, I really appreciate it.
Yeah, I appreciate you coming out.
Yeah,
no problem. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's a great event, man. Yeah, and I'm really thankful I was able to get a good signal.
Yeah.
A lot of the shows, like Lancaster, I can't get a signal, because I would love to go live over there, you know?
Exactly. Right here in the center of town is pretty good. We're picking up Kingdom Grill Wi-Fi from over here. It's public Wi-Fi, so you kind of get dropped. You can get dropped if it's too populated. But you can pick it up, so.
Yeah.
I was glad about it. I can run the tunes on my Spotify.
Oh, right. Yeah, sweet. Nice. That's cool.
Yeah.
So cool. That's it. Well, I think I'm going to shut this down, this live thing, because I've had it going well over an hour.
Yeah.
And it won't show me what my battery life is, and I'm getting concerned.
Oh, I gotcha.
But to everybody watching, thank you so much. I may or may not come on a little later, but thank you so much.